Hi everyone. In last lecture, we will discuss the evaluation of linear differential equation by variation of parameter method, and we work on those example which is a second order linear differential equation. That is, we discuss the method one, that is the solution of linear differential equation of second order by variation of parameter. So in this lecture, we'll continue the same topic but for third order linear differential equation, that is a method number two. So let's start with today's topic. So we know that the linear differential equation is of the form f of d into y is equal to x, and the complete solution is given by complementary function plus particular integral. Now the first method here, that we have to find the complementary function. So what is the procedure to find this type of equation? So first step is find complementary function, which is equal to c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus c3 y3. Okay, so whatever the value of complementary function, we have to equate this equation to this equation, that is c1y1 plus c2y2 plus c3y3. Because we already know that the equation is third order, means we have three roots, therefore we have the three constant corresponding to three function. So we compare this complementary function with c1y1 plus c2y2 plus c3y3, and find or we get value of y1, y2 and y3. How we get the value of y1, y2, y3? That is comparing with this equation. So we get the values of y1, y2, y3. Now in second step, we have to find the Wronskian. As we know that in previous method we find the Wronskian, but there are only two functions are available. So find the Wronskian, that is w is equal to, here the three functions are available. The Wronskian is given by y1, y2, y3, y1 dash, y2 dash, y3 dash. And here we have a 3 by 3 determinant. So y1 dash, double dash, y2 double dash, and y3 double dash. So find the Wronskian by using this method. Now, after finding the Wronskian, we have to write the solution of particular integral. So therefore, particular integral is equal to u y1 plus v y2 plus w y3. So in last lecture we will find the particular integral for second order differential equation. So there are only two functions, u and v. Here there are the third variable, so there are the three constant, three function y1, y2, y3, and associate with these three function we have three function for the particular integral, that is u, v and w. So where the value of u, v and w are given by some results. So first value, where u equal to, the value is integration of determinant of. So here we have to consider the determinant of 2 by 2. So first here we have to find the value of u, and the function is y1 is present with respect to u, so we eliminate this y1 and the remaining function as y2 and y3. So we have to use y2 and y3 here. So first function is y2, second function is y3, derivative of y2, derivative of y3 अपॉन द वैल्यू ऑफ रॉन्सकियन इंटू एक्स इंटू टी एक्स. सो दिस इज द फार्मूला टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ यू. सिमिलरली द वैल्यू ऑफ वी इज गिवन बाय इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वी इज एसोसिएट विद द वाई टू. सो निग्लेक्ट दिस वाई टू. सो रिमेनिंग टर्म इज वाई वन वाई थ्री वाई वन डैश वाई थ्री डैश अपॉन डब्ल्यू दिस इज रॉन्सकियन एक्स डी एक्स. बट हियर द साइन इज माइनस. फर्स्ट टर्म द साइन इज प्लस, सेकेंड टर्म द साइन इज माइनस एंड द थर्ड वैल्यू डब्ल्यू. सो डब्ल्यू इज गिवन बाय इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ W is associated with the third equation, that is y3 or third function y3. So we neglect the y3. So we get y1, y2, y1 dash, y2 dash upon Wronskian x dx. So this is the formula to obtain the value of u, v and w. After getting the value of u, v, w, we have to put this value in this formula, that is u, v and w multiplied by y1, y2 and y3 respectively. Evaluating this equation, we get the value of particular integral. So in last, we have to just add complementary function and particular integral. So therefore, complementary function, complete solution is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So complementary function, complete solution means value of y is equal to complementary function c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus c3 y3 and the value of particular integral is u y1 plus v y2 plus w y3. So this is the solution of differential equation of third order by variation of parameter. So we just find the value of y1, y2, y3, u, v, w. These are the different from different differential equation. Putting this value in this equation, we get the required solution. So with the help of this method, we can solve any differential equation of third order by using variation of parameter. So you just remember the procedure to evaluating this differential equation by using this method. If you know how to solve this differential equation, so the problem is easily solved. So with the help of this, we start with the one problem, which is of course linear differential equation of third order with constant coefficient. So we start with the example. Solve d cube plus d y is equal to cosec x by variation of parameter. So solution. Okay, so first of all we have to find the complementary function, and with the help of complementary function we can find the particular integral. So first, given differential equation is d cube plus d into y is equal to cosec x, called as equation number 1. This equation is already in symbolic form, so there is no need to convert in symbolic form again. So we directly write the complementary function and then particular integral. So first, what is the complete solution of this equation? So the complete solution is given by complete solution equal to complementary function plus particular integral. And the complete solution is equal to the variable y, where the derivative of that variable exists, means it is a dependent variable present in linear differential equation. So here dependent variable is y. So complete solution is nothing but the value of y, which is equal to value of complementary function plus particular integral. Suppose this is called the equation number 2. Now After that, we have to obtain the complementary function and particular integral. So first, to find the complementary function. So for complementary function, we have to write the auxiliary equation. So first, the auxiliary equation is So for auxiliary equation, we have to write the left hand side of given linear differential equation, that is d cube dy, and put right hand side equal to 0. So from this we get d cube plus d equal to 0. Taking d as common, we get d square plus 1 equal to 0. From this equation we obtain d equal to 0 and d square plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so d equal to 0 and d square equal to minus 1. Shifting 1 on another side, we get minus 1, and minus 1 is nothing but the value of I square. So we get d equal to 0 and d equal to, that is like taking square root on both sides, the square root of I square is I, which is plus minus. So there are the three roots. One is 0, second is I, and third is minus I. And differential equation is of third order, so we get three roots. So out of this, this first root is real and these roots are complex, that is a pair of complex number. We can also written as alpha plus minus I beta. So in this method, to write the value of complementary function, we have to use both the cases. So complementary function equal to, for real roots we use c e to the power mx. There is only one real root, so there is only one term, that is c e to the power mx. And there are the two complex roots. So for complex roots, the formula is e to the power alpha x c cos beta x plus c sin beta x. And we choose a different constant. So we write this constant as c1, this is c2, and last is c3. And this is the value for m. Alpha is absent here, the value is 0, and beta means the coefficient of I, which is equal to 1. So put this value in this equation, we get complementary function equal to c1 e to the power m1 is 0, 0 into x, alpha is again 0, 0 into x, c2 cos beta, beta is 1, 1x, c3 sin 1x, it is x. Now e to the power 0 is 1, so we simply write as c1. Again e to the power 0x is 1, so here we get c2 cos x plus c3 sin x. Okay, so this is the value for complementary function. Now next step is to find the particular integral. But please note that here we have to find the particular integral by using variation of parameter. Otherwise, the problem is asked for variation of parameter. And if you try to solve this problem by different method, means some shortcut methods or general method, answer will be correct. But we get a zero mark for the particular integral, because in this problem we have to find the particular integral only by using variation of parameter. Okay, so we try to solve the particular integral by VOP method. So for VOP method, first we have to write the complementary function. So complementary function is equal to c1 plus c2 cos x plus c3 sin x. Now first step is comparing with c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus c3 y3. So comparing with, have to compare the complementary function equal to c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus c3 y3. By comparing, we get the value of y1. The coefficient of c1 is 1, So y1 is 1, the value of y2, the coefficient of c2 is cos x, then cos x, and the value of y3, that is the coefficient of c3, is equal to sin x. Now, to find the particular integral, we need a derivative of this term. So, we find the derivative. So, first is y1 dash. 1 is constant, so derivative is 0. Second is y2 dash. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. And third is y3 dash. Derivative of sin x is cos x. Again, we need a second order derivative also. So, we again differentiate this term. y1 double dash, derivative of 0 is 0. y2 double dash, derivative of sin x is cos x. So, we get minus cos x. And y3 double dash, derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So, these are the function y1, y2, y3. And these are the first order and second order derivative of respective function, which is used to find the value of Wronski. Next, now in next step, we have to find the Wronskian. So next, Wronskian is given by, so write the formula to find the value of Wronskian. The formula is given by W is equal to determinant of y1, y2, y3. y1 dash, y2 dash, y3 dash, y1 double dash, y2 double dash, and y3 double dash. Now just put the value of all these variables, which we discuss in previous step. The value of y1 is 1, the value of y2 is cos x, the value of y3 is sin x. The value of his derivative is 0. That is a minus sin x and cos x, and the double derivative is 0 minus cos x minus sin x. So this is a determinant of 3/3. So simply solve this determinant, we get the value of Wronski. So by solving this determinant, we get 1 into, how to solve the determinant? Everyone is already know how to solve the determinant. So first we take 1, delete the row and the column in which the element is present. So we have to obtain the determinant of remaining element. So here we have to obtain this determinant. So minus sin x into minus sin x, it is sin square x minus, and the minus in determinant we get plus, cos into cos is cos square x. Minus second term is cos x, we get this term 0 and this term is 0. So 0 minus 0. Last is sin x, we get 0 and a 0. So again we get 0 minus 0. So sin square x plus cos square x is 1. So we get here 1 into 1 is 1 and this value is 0. So Wronskian is given by equal to 1. So by using this Wronskian, we have to find the value of particular integral. Now next, to find the particular integral. Okay. So to find the particular integral, we have to need the value of particular integral. So what is the formula to find the particular integral? So particular integral is given by uy1 plus vy2 plus wy3, called as equation number, what is equation number? Suppose 3. I think 1 and 2 equation we already noted in above example. So we get this equation number 3. Where? Now, here we have to find the value of u, v and w. And once we get the value of u, v, w, we directly substitute with along the values of y1, y2, y3. So we get the required value of particular integral. So where the formula for u is given by integration of u, the corresponding function is y1, so neglect this y1. So we get y2, y3, y2 dash, y3 dash upon Wronskian w x dx. Now putting this value in this equation, we get, put the value of y1, y3. So integration of the value of y1 is cos x, and the value of, sorry, value of y2 is cos x, and the value of y3 is sin x. The derivative of cos x is minus sin x, and derivative of sin x is cos x. The Wronskian is 1, so this determinant upon 1, so we get the determinant itself, and the value of x is cosec x dx. Now first we have to solve this determinant. So cos into cos, cos square x, minus minus plus sin square x into cosec x dx. Now cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So here we get the integration of cosec x dx. Now what is the integration of cosec x? Log of cosec x minus cot x. So log of cosec x minus cot x. So this is the value for first function, that is u. Now next we have to find the value for the second function, that is v. So next the formula for v is given by minus integration of determinant. Now here v is associated with the second function y2. So we just neglect y2, and the determinant is given by y1, y3, y1 dash, y3 dash upon Wronskian w into dx, which is equal to minus integration of, now put the values for y1. So y1 is 1, y3 is sin x, derivative of y1 is 0, derivative of sin x is minus cos x. Now the value of Wronskian is 1, so this determinant divided by 1, which is the value of determinant, the value of x is cosec x dx. Now we have to solve this determinant and this integration. We get, which is equal to minus integration of, now solving this determinant we get 1 into minus cos x, so we get minus cos x, 0 into sin x is 0, and here we get the integration of cosec, cosec x as it is, cosec x dx. So minus minus we get a plus, so integration of cos x, and the value of, so let's do the correction here, that is integration of sin x is cos x, so here we get plus cos x, plus cos x, so here the term is minus. So cos x as it is, and cosec x can be written as 1 upon sin x dx, which is equal to minus integration of, now cos upon sin can be written as cot x dx, which is equal to minus integration of cot x is log of sin x. It is a standard result. If you don't know the standard result for cot x, we have one this formula, that is integration of f dash of x upon f of x dx is equal to log of f of x. So if we observe here, the term is sine, and derivative of sine is cos x is present here, so we can directly apply this result, so we get this answer. So this is the value for v. Next we have to obtain the value for another function w. So value for w, the formula for w is given by integration of, now w is associated with the third value, that is y3, so neglect this y3. So we get y1, y2, y1 dash, y2 dash upon w into x dx, which is equal to inclination. What is the value for y1? It is 1. Value of y2 is cos x. Derivative of this one is 0. And the derivative of this cos x is minus sin x. Again, the Wronskian is 1. So, this determinant upon 1 is this determinant itself. And the value of x is cosec x. Integration with respect to x. Now, solve this in, determinant first and then evaluate the integral. So, which is equal to? Integration of. First, solve the determinant. 1 into minus sin x. We get minus sin x. And 0 into this cos x is 0. So, we get minus sin x into cosec x dx, which is equal to minus, taking outside the integral, sin x. And the cosec x can be written as 1 upon sin x dx. Sin x get cancelled. So, we get minus integration of dx. And what is the integration of dx is x. So, we get value as minus x. After finding the all the values of u, v and w, and we already know the value of y1, y2 and y3, we obtained the particular integral. So, particular from equation 3, the formula for particular integral is given by particular integral is equal to u y1 plus v y2 plus w y3. Now here we just put the values of u, v and w. So this particular integral is equal to the value of u is, we already obtained the value of u is log of cosec x minus cot x. The value of y is given by 1 plus the value of v is minus log of sin x. The value of y2 is given by cos x. And lastly, the value of w is minus x and the value of y3 is sin x. By arranging all this value, we get log of cosec x minus cot x plus minus, that is a minus, sin x into log of sin x plus minus is again minus x sin x. So this is the value of particular integral for given linear differential equation. So at last we add complementary function and particular integral, so we obtain the value of complex solution. So therefore complex solution is given by complementary function plus particular integral. The complex solution is nothing but the value of a dependent variable. So in this example, y is a dependent variable. So value of y is given by complementary function plus particular integral. So here we have to just put the value of complementary function and particular integral. So y is equal to, the complementary function is given by c1, c2 cos x plus c3 sin x. And the value for particular integral is given by this term. It is plus log of cosec x minus cot x minus sin x into log of sin x minus x sin x. So this is our final answer of complex solution for given linear differential equation using a method of variation of parameter. So in this example we learn how to solve the linear differential equation of third order by using variation of parameter. In last lecture we already discussed the solution of linear differential equation of second order by variation of parameter. So, using this method, you can solve the any problem by using VOP. Just we have to do some practice for different example. And once your concept is clear, so you can easily solve this type of problem. So thanks for watching.